Hi there. I'm again in Chateau Montjoie, where second edition of our poetry retreat has just ended a few days ago. And I'm going to teach you and share some ideas about giant tribute weaves and meltdowns, which is this. And this. And the combinations.
Go away! Go away!
All right, no more dinos. So, I'm going to show you some basic tree bead weave patterns and what they can progress into. As I've always been I really like this move, especially in backwards. It's always been feeling really nice. And you can really nicely walk with it. It's a bit elegant, feels like that to me. And same in forwards, going like that. And then I was thinking, how does this actually work? I noticed this is just like a giant three-bead weave. So observe this progress. If I'm spinning three-bead weave backwards, and the hand that goes on top of the other, which is now with my left going over right on the right side, and the right going on the left side, over the left, or also it's, you know, each hand is doing two circles on the opposite side and one on the native. So it's the second circle that is important for now. If I start putting it higher and higher, and extending both hands, especially the top one, and higher even above my head. And if I go even further, if I put it above the opposite shoulder, I'm gonna have to start moving my whole body. It turns into this. And again, I can go smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller, and I'm back in the 3-bead weave. And the same thing works with forwards. If I got the forwards weave, and now the hand that twists around the other hand, so right twisting above left on the right side, left above right on the left side, I start putting it higher and higher and higher. Higher and all the way above my head, and eventually above. Please. And eventually, I'm going to put it above the shoulder. It turns into that. So once you get this down, few things you should observe about this move is. It's really important to move your shoulders well and the upper part of your body to find the right flow and find an effortless way to do that. So if I just did it with my shoulders and isolated my hand, that would really feel bad. So I'm moving my whole torso. You can add one step forward, front and back, or you can just stand still and move your body. But this motion should be there, for sure. Another thing to observe is, this is basically a transition from windmill and extension on one side, and windmill and extension on the other. So you can also use that like a transition between this, and that, also an extra turn. And there's a moment when there's a small circle and extension, right? Circle above the head, extension. Circle, or above, more like behind, extension. Circle behind, extension. Circle behind, extension. And that's both in backwards and forwards. So circle behind, extension. Circle behind, extension. Circle behind, extension. You can choose if that's just going to be a circle, or you can try to isolate it a little bit to add some different feeling to that. You can choose how much the extension is going to be extended. So it can be extended a lot, or it can be extended a little bit. With some, a little bit of an isolation, it can look very nice. It could even be something like this. right?
So once you get comfortable with backwards and forwards, you can start combining them. So let's say, and follow me so it's easier for you to understand and don't make any mistake. We're going forwards in the moment when my left passes my right ear, when the left is in the bag. I'm opening up to the right, turning right, following my right hand, and going all the way with my into backwards when right goes behind. Yeah? So from left behind into right behind. Also show like this. From left behind, so from now into right behind. And back, so left behind, extension, right behind. Again, if I shorted this pattern, would again turn it into something like a weave, right? But this would be two beats, and two beats. So if I don't put the hands all the way behind my head, I just go down, I realize that what I'm doing is this. It's just interesting to observe. Yeah. This is where we want to incorporate some other body position and my hand position to get some different looks. So this is one way to do it with extensions. Or in this moment when I'm transitioning from forwards to backwards, I can start tracing around my head and my neck. So I'm going tracing around and going back. Tracing around, I can go with extension, or I can shorter the hands and they can just go kind of behind my body. You might notice a similarity between this movement from going from backwards to forward. This really feels the same like what the hands are doing when you're doing the 4x4 fountain. You could also enter from the 4x4 fountain. This is the 4x4 fountain. Yeah. Another version of this move is the down below version. So just like we can do this, we can do this. Right? So to enter this one, you can follow the same steps, like slowly exchanging this with this. So instead of my left going above, go behind. So now it's not instead of above, the left doesn't go instead of above, but instead of under, it goes behind my body. Instead of this, instead of right going under, left goes behind my body on the other side. So this and this, and this and that. You can practice it slowly. So from this, right behind and left on the right side, and left behind and right on the right. And up and up. Same thing forwards. So as my left would go under right on the right side, it's gonna go behind. And the same thing with the right. Up, up. Basically what happens is that I'm kind of becoming, and I got into the center of the wheel. If I manipulate myself into this tribute beef pattern, that's what's technically in this move. So once you get this and that, you can add extensions. So from here, as my left goes behind the back, right extends, as right goes behind the back, left extends and right follows. So there's a moment where both are extended, and again a moment when there's a circle and extension. So the same thing like in this one, right? Hop, hop. Same thing in forwards, then add extension. Hop, 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 hop. And then I can combine that. So from this one, when my right is behind the back, I'm turning all the way to the left behind the back, and back to the right behind the back, and to the left behind, and right behind the back, and left behind the back.
And that slowly turns. If I take off my body movement, so turning 180, if I just try to stand still and do this with my hands, it turns into this, the meltdown. And those two can be combined very nicely. So, for instance, just combining this and that can be interesting. You can even make an ultimate combination of both, like this. So one goes behind the body and the other one goes behind the head, which is interesting. Basically, it's like a behind the back tribute weave, but one is down low and the other one is above. Even in forwards. And find some nice combinations between those. Then add some turns. Hop. Yeah, it's a lot to find. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial and hope to make some more soon. Hopefully earlier than in a year, but never know.